90% of Dutch people speak English fluently. No, I don't think you get how crazy that is. 90%. For reference, only 85% of Canadians speak English. They've certainly got the best English level in Europe, and they've often been ranked as the best in the world. They're so crazy good at English that some Dutch people have argued that English is no longer a foreign language in the Netherlands. But this success story did not happen by chance. In this video, I'll go over the 5 reasons why the Dutch are so good at English, and how you can learn from them to improve your language learning. And then afterwards, we'll look into the looming question, will English completely replace Dutch in the future? But first, let's look at reason number 1. The Dutch think internationally, but not necessarily because they want to. Let me explain. Just look at the Netherlands for a second. They're small, they don't have many mineral resources, and a third of their land is under sea level, which explains all the canals everywhere. So they need trade with other countries to literally survive. Luckily, they're right at the crossroads of 3 European giants, France, Germany, and England. The Dutch realized pretty quickly that these guys weren't gonna learn Dutch. So they were like, guys, we gotta learn other languages or else no one's gonna trade with us. So that's exactly what they did. If you were a Dutch kid in the 16th century, you weren't just learning Dutch in school, you were learning French in a bilingual school. Get to the 18th century and German starts becoming the hot new language. So by the time English was in vogue following World War II, the Netherlands were well prepared. And to this day, the Dutch realize that the key to staying afloat in a globalized world is foreign languages. In fact, in comparison with other Europeans, Dutch people are nearly 20 times more likely to believe that Europeans should be able to speak a second language in addition to their mother tongue. The takeaway here for us is that you shouldn't just want to learn your target language, you should need to learn it. And if you don't feel like you need to learn it right now, well then put yourself in a situation where you will need to learn it. So for instance, you're learning Italian, don't go to an international hostel where you have the option to speak English. No. Go to some small Italian village where you need to speak Italian to eat and drink and survive. Because as the Dutch know, if you feel like you need to learn a language, then you will end up learning it. But this drive isn't the only reason why the Dutch have mastered English, which brings me to reason number 2. English is everywhere. Signs are in English, murals are in English, ads are in English. They often just watch American or British TV programs and movies, and they almost never dub them. It's always with subtitles. No offense, but the Dutch aren't really well known for their quality television.
Hey, Bala!
And all this exposure is really important because before the Dutch even learn a single word of English in the education system, they've already been exposed to it a lot. They've seen it, they've heard it, they know how it should sound. And the numbers prove it. 84% of Dutch people said that a big factor in their language learning was media, like TV and books. So that's our takeaway. Immerse yourself in the language. Spend a lot of time on your phone, go to the settings and change the language to your target language. Do you check the news every day? Read articles in your target language. Do you love YouTube videos and movies? Well then download the app FluentU. It basically teaches you language exclusively through authentic movie scenes and YouTube videos. Plus it has interactive subtitles so you can always follow along. We're actually offering free trials of FluentU, so if you're interested, go to the link in the description below. Now on to number 3, the Dutch teach differently. In 1993, the European Union was established, with English as the lingua franca between nations. And it's no coincidence that that very year, the Netherlands made a giant education reform where English became a core subject alongside Dutch and math. Ever since, English has been a mandatory subject for all Dutch high school students, no matter if they're trying to go to university or if they're going a more vocational path. So to reach this ambitious goal, the Dutch have developed a unique teaching method, which starts when they're just little tykes. Around age 4 or 5, many Dutch kids start early foreign language education, or vroeg vreemdtalenonderwijs, VVTO for short. This isn't conjugation charts and flashcards. No, these students have fun. They play games, they sing songs. And VVTO is often put in schools at the request of parents who want their kids to learn English this way. So by the time they get to high school, most Dutch kids have a pretty good grasp on the English language. So at that point, they can step up their language learning to the next level by going to bilingual high school. And then afterwards, they can choose to get a college degree that is partially or completely offered in English. This way, the Dutch learn English by using it, not by memorizing it. And that's our big takeaway. Learn by doing. If you like music, don't just memorize a list of 50 musical vocabulary words. No, go learn a song in your target language or take music lessons in the language. Your brain will start to absorb the words much better and easier if you're using them to interpret a message or to accomplish a goal. But I have a bit of a confession to make, which is, yes, the Dutch are really good at learning languages, but they also have a bit of an advantage over other countries. And that has to do with the fact that Dutch is similar to English. Very similar, actually. It's the closest living language to English besides Frisian, which is also spoken in the Netherlands. Let me just show you a few example sentences in Dutch. Dat is een kat. That is a cat. Ik heb water. I have water. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And those are just the ones that I found by messing around on Google Translate for 2 minutes. I'm sure there are many other examples. And on top of that, the Dutch people have spoken English for so long that they've adopted a lot of loan words from English, like bad hair day or intensive care. So what's our takeaway here? Hack the language by identifying patterns. Like in Portuguese, for instance, cooperação looks like cooperation. And organização looks like organization. So when you see a são, you can guess what the word is. Don't memorize 100 words if you can just learn one rule. But the Netherlands' great English success story goes deeper than just these linguistic similarities. There's also just a very deep cultural connection. Specifically, English has a special status in Dutch culture. During World War II, Germany invaded the Netherlands. So Queen Wilhelmina and the Dutch government had to escape somewhere. They decided to take refuge across the channel in England. And in a few years, it would be the Americans and the Canadians who would help the Netherlands break from German rule. Before this point, English might have been seen as some sort of second-rate language to French or to German. But now, with the US becoming an emerging superpower and the UK becoming a very close ally of the Netherlands, many Dutch people saw English as the future of the Western world. As one Dutch historian puts it, English was the language of the liberators, the money providers, and progress. And even into the 21st century, English has a special status in the eyes of many Dutch people. Many advertisers have gone on the record saying that they prefer to have their ads in English because to them, English is associated with, quote, a young, dynamic, international lifestyle. And English can, quote, convey an air of modernity and progress. The simple truth is we learn languages better when we feel compelled to do it, not just because somebody else is telling us to. That's why so many Americans learn French for 5 years, and then once they leave school, they can't say a single word besides merci. Many Dutch people feel this cultural connection to English, and for that reason, they feel personally invested in the language learning process. So, takeaway number 5 is to find the meaning in the language, or rather, to find your meaning. This could come from looking at the history of the language, or it could come from looking at the future of the language, how this target language might open up doors for you. Wherever you find it, recognizing this meaning is what separates casual learners from dedicated polyglots. And now for the big question. Will English replace Dutch in the future? Well, we here at FluentU can't predict the future, but based on the research, it looks like the signs point to no. And it has everything to do with this special status that English has in Dutch culture. Surveys show that it is true that most Dutch people enjoy speaking English and do not resent having to use it, but they also prefer to speak in Dutch whenever possible, and tend to only speak English with non-Dutch people or native English speakers. And while some institutions like universities are offering English-only courses or programs, this isn't across the board, and this tends to be only more with internationally minded disciplines. Disciplines like law and medicine continue to be taught exclusively in Dutch, and it doesn't look like it's gonna be changing anytime soon. English is 100% additive. It doesn't take anything away from Dutch, but it gives the Dutch people another dimension for understanding their world. One person who found this extra dimension was the iconic Hollywood actress Audrey Hepburn, who spoke fluent Dutch and English, as well as 4 other languages. And you can learn all about her in this other video we made about famous celebrity polyglots, some of whom were really surprising actually, like Tom Hiddleston and Natalie Portman. So, if that sounds interesting to you, check out the video on this screen and I'll see you.